so unreasonable.
It's a gift.
Don't worry, honey. I'll think of something.
Sure she will, Sam. Nell knows how to get around Dad.
Well, I learned from the best, your mother.
Well, you met Mom in Chicago, didn't you?
Oh, yeah. She was on her way to see her family to try and explain again why she married your father.
Oh, yeah, I remember that. You guys got snowed in and had to spend a night together.
No, it was two nights. See, all flights were canceled, and the airline tried to get us to spend the night on a bench in the terminal.
You slept on those hard benches?
Oh, no. Your mother told the airline that we were undercover reporters for Walter Cronkite. So the next thing we knew, we had the presidential suite at the Ritz-Carlton, baby.
Sounds like you two had a lot of fun together.
Oh, we did. The next time I saw Margaret was in 1974. It's been 10 years since I met your kids. Yeah, and I was introduced to your father. You talk about an introduction? That was an introduction. You want to talk about an introduction?
Well, why? What happened?
I can't talk about it.
Oh, no, no.
You got to promise not to tell your father.
Promise.
Okay, okay. Sit down. Promise.
Yes.
Okay. Well, I had just come out to California to do my first gig out here, nightclub, you know? Well, I was a starring act, the headliner at Mr. Funky's in Fresno. Well, anyway, it was my opening night, and your mother came in.
Sings just like a nightingale. Me, I sing like a night in jail, but don't fall. So I want you to drink up, cause Mr. Funky needs the money. I should know I'm Mr. Funky. Woo, boy, get out of here.
Rich, what are you doing here?
Yeah, I found this in my luggage when I got back from Chicago. Are these yours?
Margaret, I don't wear purple pantyhose.
Liar.
I've been looking for these for over a year, girl.
Sit down, sit down. What are you doing here in town?
I read about your opening tonight, and my home in Glenlawn's only an hour away, so here I am. Well, how do you like California so far?
Well, the weather is terrific, but these people are weird. Your governor is Ronald Reagan? Is your husband Carl with you?
Oh, no, he's a cop. He's working the night shift. Oh, by the way, he's a lieutenant now.
That's wonderful. It's just every time I think of you or Chicago, I have to laugh.
Well, sure. I was the one who got locked out of the hotel room when I went for ice. And had to go down to the front desk to get an extra key in my nightgown.
What are you complaining about? Half of the hotel lobby followed you back to your room. If you hadn't been married, we could have had a party, girl.
Now, could I see you for a second, baby?
If he babies me one more time, I'm gonna set fire to his toupee. What is it, Mr. Funky?
Look, dump that dame. I got the cold duck. We'll go to my room.
Look, I don't want cold duck or hot coming, okay?
Hey, you wanna keep your job? I'm the boss, and what I say goes, so.
Okay. Well, say now, because I'm gone.
All right.
Come on. Let's get out of here. I just quit my job.
What?
Mr. Funky wants me to do three shows a night, two up there on stage and one in his room.
Well, what are you going to do now?
Hey, no problem. I have $80. I just go back to Alabama and wait for my next gig.
Wait a second. Better idea.
Come out, come out, wherever you are. Come out, wherever you are. Come out, come out, wherever you are.
Okay, gang, front and center.
Hi.
Kids, I want you to meet my friend Nell.
Hi.
Nell, this is Katie, my 8-year-old. And this is Julie, my 6-year-old.
I'm going to be 7.
Now, you told me they were beautiful, but she didn't tell me you were smart, too.
Then I'm going to be 8 years old, then 9, 10, 11.
Julie.
Someday I'll be as old as you.
Leslie, this is Mel.
Hi.
Hi.
Where's the baby?
Samantha's hiding. We're playing hide and seek.
Closet.
I wonder where Samantha could be. I don't know where Samantha could be.
Here I am.
There she is.
Samantha, I want you to meet my friend Nell.
Hi, precious. Oh, aren't you a little darling?
I found a dead moth.
Oh, a dead moth. Thank you, honey. Mommy and I haven't had dinner yet. Would you like white meat or dog meat, dear?
I'll take a wing.
Yeah.
I'll be leaving, Mrs. Kaniski.
Oh, okay, Leslie. Here you go. Thank you and good night.
Thanks, Mrs. K.
Okay, girls, time for bed. Run upstairs. Say good night to Aunt Nell.
Night, Aunt Nell.
I'll be down in a minute, Nell, as soon as I tuck them in.
I'll get fed, okay? Coming!
You're not Mrs. Kaniski. Where is she?
She's upstairs. She'll be right down, but you come right on in.
I'm Bickford from across the street. This whole neighborhood is going to hell in a handbasket.
Well, I wasn't thinking of buying a house.
Oh, hi, Mr. Bickford.
I see you've met Nell.
Margaret, you keep your daughter Julie away from my little grandson. I just happened to go down to my basement, and there they were standing there in the buff. Stark naked.
Well, since they're both 6 years old, I can understand why you're upset. In the buff, you say?
Yes. Do you think this is funny?
No.
Well, I don't think your husband will think this is funny. He's a cop. He would have thrown the book at him.
What a nice, sweet, dirty old man.
Let's go over to his basement and take our clothes off. Come on, I'll show you to your room.
Okay.
You'll be sleeping in my room tonight.
This is your... Oh, Margaret, no, I can't take your room.
Oh, no, really? There's a movie I want to see on the Late Show, and then afterwards I'll just crank into the guest bedroom downstairs.
No, Margaret, please, I can't let you do this.
Really, it's more convenient for me. When Carl works all night, I do this all the time.
Are you sure?
Yes. And by the way, I am so happy that you came here.
I am too, and thank you.
And just think, you still got your $60.
Oh, no, no, I have 80.
No, no, 60. Room is 20.
Get out of here.
So the first time you and Dad met, you were in bed together.
Oh, honey. Do you know how terrifying it is to wake up in the middle of the night and find yourself butt to butt with a cop?
And Daddy wouldn't let me go to a drive-in movie.
Anyway, your mother told me that I could stay on until I got my next gig. So for the next 5 weeks, we had a blast.
Hi, darling. I'm sorry we took so long shopping.
Actually, I missed you a lot.
Honey, not in front of...
You should have been with us, Carl. The department store was mobbed.
You know, there were so many people at that sale, we couldn't get near the shoe counter.
Yeah, that's when Margaret fainted. So while everybody gathered around her, I bought 3 pairs of shoes.
That was a lousy thing to do.
It's no big thing. I fainted for her in lingerie.
Nell, nothing personal, but have you got a job yet?
No, but it's awfully nice to know that you're interested in my career.
Anything to help. Look, if it's a matter of transportation, I could get one of the guys to run you to the state line.
It's nice of you, Carl, but there's nothing over the state line but desert.
I know. Well, I gotta get ready for work.
Well, I think I have overstayed my welcome,
honey. Oh, no, Nell, no, that's just Carl talking.
Mommy, I'm here, yay!
Ah, kids, hey, listen, baby. It's time for you to go wash up for dinner.
Do we have to? Can Aunt Nell tell us a story first?
Oh, honey, no. Aunt Nell's tired. She's been shopping.
No. I've got... Get down here. I'll tell you one. Come on over here. All right, get over here. I'm going to tell you the story about the 2 crows, okay? Once upon a time, there were 2 crows. There was Katie Crow and Julie Crow. Well, Katie Crow and Julie Crow didn't see the wolf, Mr. Funky, sneaking up on them because he was dressed in sheep's clothing.
He even had a sheep's toupee.
Well, just as he was about to grab Katie Crow and Julie Crow, Mama Crow came flying out of the cornfield on her broom.
Her broom?
A broom. This is my story. Anyway, Mama Crow told Mr. Funky the Wolf, you can't have Crow Burger because you didn't wash your hands.
Nell, I hope there's a moral to this story.
There is. Listen, girls. If you're going to have dinner with a wolf in a toupee, make sure he washes his hands. You understand? You got it?
You see okay. That, girls? Okay. Now go upstairs, get your sister, and wash your hands.
Faster upstairs to the Crow Burger.
No. Maybe you have overstayed your welcome. The girls hate you. Oh.
Hi, Carl. Here's your electric drill I borrowed. Hey, that carbide bit works like a charm.
I told you it would.
Oh, say, about the kids, I punished Bobby, so it's all right if he and Julie play together again.
What'd they do?
Didn't Margaret tell you? They were naked in my basement.
Must have slipped my mind. Yeah. See ya.
Naked!
Margaret, get down here! Margaret!
What is it, darling?
Don't darling me, honey. You do this every time, Margaret. Something happens, you don't tell me about it. Then when you tell me, it's like nothing really happened. By that time, I'm so steamed up, I say something stupid, you cry, and then I feel guilty. But it's not going to happen this time.
Carl, before we continue this discussion, did I tell you that Julie and Bobby Bickford were naked together?
You see, you just did it.
But they're only children, Carl.
You stay out of this. We never had a nudity problem until you got here.
Oh, Carl, they're 6 years old. It was totally innocent.
Innocent?
Carl, children have a natural curiosity about their bodies. I mean, it's not the same as... when I saw you in your shorts... was the opposite of innocence.
Opposite?
Carl, the sight of you in your underwear stirred feelings in me that I didn't even know existed.
Yeah?
I mean, even now, the picture of it just flashes across my mind. Oh, Lord, protect me from lust.
Lust?
Lust.
Protect her, Lord.
Amen.
Carl, Nell and I had a woman-to-woman talk, and I forgave her because I knew what the sight of you and your boxers had done to me for all these years.
I've been meaning to pick up a few more pairs.
So, what is it that you wanted to talk to me about, Carl?
Nothing. Well, I'd better be getting to work. I may be a little late tonight, but we can sure use the overtime. Oh, by the way, Nell, for what it's worth, my old hygiene teacher told me that taking a cold shower sometimes helps.
You are evil. Hello? Yes, she is. It's for you. Bakersfield.
Bakersfield, hope it's a job. Hello? Yes, this is Nell Hopper. It's Fred's Lounge in Bakersfield. Yes. I'm available. Yeah, I just have to, you know, find it when the next bus leaves. Oh, can you call me back in a few minutes? Okay. Bye. Wow!
Sounds like you got a job.
Well, it's not the greatest job in the world, but it's a start. I mean, so what if I live in a rooming house or even some crummy diner? Oh, I'm so excited. I just gotta find out what time the next bus leaves.
Too soon.
Say what, babe? You know, Margaret, I want you to come and see me in about 3 weeks when I really get my act back into shape, okay?
Well, I'll try. Can't promise.
What do you mean you can't promise? You're on the fan club I got, girl.
I'm dying now.
Yeah. That's not funny, Margaret. Margaret? Oh, my God. Margaret. Does anyone else know?
No, no. And I don't want Carl to know until he has to.
Margaret.
No, come on, Harper. No, I've lived with this for 4 months, and I will be damned if I will go out crying.
All right. Okay.
Besides, I mean, it's not like we're not ever going to see each other again. You're not going to live forever either. And when we do meet again, I want you to promise me one thing.
Anything.
Don't wear that dress.
She's insane!
Now, I want you to raise my girls.
What are you talking about?
Well, I've been watching how wonderful you are with the girls. They love you.
Wait. You've been watching me?
Well, Carl can't raise them. He loves them and he'll try, but his answer to everything is to yell at them. They need you, Nell. And the minute that you walked into this house, I knew that you were the answer to my prayers.
No. 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 The good Lord did not send me here to help raise the Trapp family. I am not Julie Andrews. You into your house. You're nice to me. You become my friend. You get me to fall in love with those adorable little brats, and then you pour this on me, Margaret. That's low. That takes the cake.
You know, sweetheart, you can yell all you want to. I know you care.
Yes, I care about me. I got a life to live. I don't have time to be wiping noses here in Glen Lawn. I got a future in Bakersfield. It's probably my future there. Hello? Yes. This is Nell Hopkins. Can you speak up?
Children, I can't.
No. I can't hear you. Yes. There is a bus leaving tomorrow for Bakersfield. But, listen, I won't be on it. I got some noses to wipe, okay? Bye-bye.
Mom was a great lady.
She sure was. Whenever you were down, you could count on Margaret to make you laugh.
Yeah. And she had the last laugh, too. She stuck me with you all these years.
Chief, dear, being with you hasn't exactly been over the rainbow for me either. What about Samantha going to the drive-in movie?
Absolutely not.
All right, I'll go with her, okay?
All right, if you're going, I guess... All right, you can go.
Hooray. I don't think Martin's gonna be too thrilled about having a chaperone along.
That's why I'm calling James. We're going in separate cars.